Duchenne muscular dystrophy is a disease that's impacted my younger brother, Terry, as well as my mother's three brothers and her mother's brother as well. And so it's impacted over three generations of my family. Duchenne is a muscle wasting disease that is fatal. It impacts cardiac and skeletal muscle, and currently there's no effective treatment for the population of patients, which number about 15,000 in the United States. It's specifically caused by a mutation in the dystrophin gene. It's hard to treat because the gene is large and it's a structural gene. It's very hard to deliver to muscle systemically throughout the body. Muscle is about 40% of our body mass and ranges everywhere from our head down to our toes and sort of everywhere in between. I'd grown up sort of through middle school, high school, and college watching Terry get weaker and weaker. It started to prompt these feelings of, I need to do something. And it was there where I decided I need to start a nonprofit. I need to talk and meet as many scientists as possible. We didn't know what technology would work well here, but what we started with was what we knew, which was let's do a muscle biopsy. The muscle biopsy allowed us to create a cell line that we could then test candidate therapeutics against. We, in parallel, also conducted whole genome sequencing. With whole genome sequencing, you're able to identify the breakpoints of the mutation. We then also did RNA sequencing, and that helped to inform us to be able to identify a super novel technology called the CRISPR transcriptional activator. This transcriptional activator seeks to upregulate the target gene of interest. Now, Terry's mutation is unique in that it's an inactivating mutation. Using an analogy of a faucet, Terry was producing low levels of dystrophin. It was around 3%, which is not much, but it's interesting from the fact that if we could sort of take a drip, drip, drip and turn it more into a steady flow. So we leveraged the CRISPR transcriptional activator technology to target his part of the genome to basically boost the production of dystrophin. And so from there, the question came, what animal model do we use? And so that's where sort of our collaboration with Charles River and a number of other academic sites came into play. We found a humanized mouse model. We were able to breed up the colony at Charles River and then start our first pharmacology study. The collaboration with Charles River is key for a few different reasons. It offers us the flexibility to set up experiments across the world. It allows us access to an existing infrastructure that a standalone, you know, academic at fill-in-the-blank university would not have. And I think as we move forward toward more lean drug development, so too will the need grow for more support from Charles River and CROs of the like. With the initial pharmacology studies done, we approached the FDA in a pre-IND meeting. We proceeded to manufacture the GMP therapeutic. With that material in hand, we conducted our GLP toxicology study earlier in 2021. And so with that being complete, we submitted our IND here in the summer of 2022. With the FDA's approval of our IND, which is such an incredibly exciting moment to finally have reached that point after three long years, we will begin the clinical trial imminently. This journey is sort of like as raw as it gets, right? Drug development for your own brother, it's not abstract. It's very painfully, painfully real. What I didn't realize at the time that I do now is that what we are building is a framework and a system by which others could follow in the footsteps to encourage true collaboration